With every day and every poll, it's looking more and more likely National will need not just ACT, but also New Zealand First to form the next government. And you only need to watch last night's multi-party leaders debate to see why that might be a recipe for disaster.
Do you trust David Seymour?
It's not my job to trust David Seymour.
Well, it is if you're in government with him.
It's my job to convince my caucus colleagues who will make the decision, not just me, and everybody that votes for my party, that this is the thing we must do.
James,
now, you've got to establish trust, and this is not a very good start now.
Perhaps sensing its own coalition of chaos could be on the way, National has enlisted some help.
Hi, everyone. Well, with election day around the corner, people are asking me for my thoughts. So here's a couple. First, the election result is far from certain. Imagine if we woke up on the 15th of October in limbo.
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 Yeah, former Prime Minister Sir John Key is also clearly not keen on National doing the limbo. He joins us this morning.
Hey.
What made you do the video?
Oh, wanting to help, really, but mostly we're at a critical time in the election. So I think this weekend you might see 350,000, 400,000 people vote. Mobilising our base, anyone that wants change, really, really encouraging to get out and vote, and obviously party vote National. So that's what's really critical. And also the real risk of complacency. So if you go and have a look on the TAB odds in Australia of likely to win, National's $1.10. Labor's $6.50. And one of the really big risks is people that genuinely want change, want a different approach to, you know, the economy, law and order, all the things that we're concerned about, just go, oh, National will get there, I don't have to worry about it. So that was really, it was, you know, call to arms, really.
But it's not a National versus Labor thing right now, is it?
No.
It's a National split with ACT and New Zealand First, and we're seeing quite a bit of shuffling
yeah.
there. Did they ask you to do that video, or did you offer?
No, I offered. I mean, Chris Luxon's press secretary was my former chief press secretary, so I talked to her a little bit. But I said, look, can I help? And if I can help, you know, mobilising that base we know is really important. But by the way, this MMP sort of thing, it's not new. I mean, I was in the really lucky position because people did aggressively party vote National to be able to, you know I could govern alone on the night in 08, 11 and 14. But the reality is, every election, other than actually 2020 with Jacinda, which was a highly unusual set of circumstances, requires this, you know, coalition of different partners.
Is it the look of the way things are going, though, with the polls and those odds that you talk
yeah.
about that's made you do it? Because you said only recently in an article, I'm
yeah.
not actively looking to be part of the political discourse.
Correct.
That's quite a direct statement.
Yeah, yeah, that was a direct statement. And I hope people follow it. I don't know if they will, but I hope they do. Look, the truth is that the invitations I get, including from the Breakfast Show, to be here have been endless. And I pretty much 99% of them say no. But equally, every so often, you know, I do get involved. My wife probably say I can't help myself. So, you know, in the middle of COVID, obviously, I wrote an opinion piece that got a fair bit of coverage. I mean, so, yeah, every so often I'll say something, but I kind of try and hold that firepower a little bit if I have any. And, you know, to be blunt, I genuinely think Chris Luxon will be a fantastic Prime Minister. If I can do anything to get him over the line, then I'm going to help.
Part of that is obviously going to be trying to temper down what
yep.
we saw last night at the leaders'
yep.
debate. So what did you make of the relationship or the communication between Winston Peters and David Seymour?
Well, in one respect, I watched the debate, actually. I mean, I think they're sort of more entertainment than educating the public. But, you know, actually a little better than I might have thought. I mean, if you look at the comments they were making about each other, say, 3 weeks ago, they were actually more aggressive. But don't forget, you know, in political campaigns, every party is talking to their base. You know, so Te Pāti Māori is talking to its base. And so lots of voters might look and say, that message doesn't resonate with me, but it'll be resonating with the people they're targeting. And so those guys are just marking their own territory with their own voters.
It's going to be tricky, though, isn't it? Because I agree, they were
yep.
talking to their own bases. But David Seymour's been really clear in the past. He was sort of saying, Winston Peters, he can't work with anybody.
Yep.
Think about how many chances this guy's had already. He was really clear. He's got the polls say he's got no chance of being back in Parliament, Seymour
yeah.
said. I mean, you're going to have to eat your own words, I suspect, numerous times in any political term.
Yeah, well,
that is not a great start if you're going to have to go into government with the guy.
We all get it wrong. I think I said that about him winning Northland, actually, in the by-election. But anyway, that's what it is. Look, here's the reality, and this is what actually everybody forgets. We have an election, right? and we're going to get a result, whatever that result is. The New Zealanders will decide that result. It doesn't matter what everybody else thinks. They'll decide. But if you're the leader of the biggest political party, you have the moral mandate and the authority to try and form a government. But let's say you can't form a government or you don't want to form a government. Then your next option is minority government, but that's inherently unstable. And then your third option is another election. So I know everybody says, oh, you know, Chris Luxon should rule out Winston Peters. Well, OK, yeah, fair enough, but if he has 58 seats on election night...
He's going to try his darndest
to make it work. Do you think New Zealanders
want
another election? Yeah. Do you think they want a minority government? They'll want everyone to play nicely. And to be fair to Winston, and everyone will know that, you know, I ruled him out in 08 because he was going with Labor, and everyone will know our relationship isn't the strongest relationship, so I get all that. But to be fair to Winston, if you look at prime ministers that have worked with him, Helen Clark, Jim Bolger, they actually spoke very well of him. And I remember when the media was saying what an amazing job he did as temporary prime minister when Jacinda was on maternity leave. So can they make it work? Yeah, they can make it work if they have to. But the truth is, what I'd like to see is the strongest National Party vote. And actually, frankly, if that vote could be 51%, then we don't have to worry about anybody. But we'll see how that goes.
Can Christopher Luxon then trust Winston Peters? We see a lot of chit-chat about whether he'll flip-flop back to Labor. Now, he's ruled them out, although some of that wording on his manifesto on his website has loosened up a little bit, and it's not quite so emphatic. Can Chris Luxon trust him?
Yeah, well, the first thing is stating the blindingly obvious. I mean, Winston hasn't been with National for 27 years. Yep. He started his political career with National, and I think a lot of his actual values and principles are with National. The other thing is he ruled Labor out. I know Chris Hipkins says, oh, I'm not dealing with you, but do you really think Chris Hipkins in 2017 was part of the group that was grovelling to Winston to make Jacinda Prime Minister? I think he was. I don't think he was sitting in the background saying, he's untrustworthy, let's give up our ministerial chances here. That's not true. Actually, Winston ruled him out. So can Chris Luxon trust Winston? I'd say, on the basis of the public comments he said, yeah, actually, probably can trust him, that he would come with National if required. The real message to our voters is, look, if you want change, the less moving parts, the better. If you want less moving parts, then that's really National. It's probably National ACT, but if it has to be other political parties, well, who knows who's in the mix? I mean, we don't know. You know, there are other political parties out there that could get there or could coalesce with National.
Where do you see ACT and New Zealand First butting heads policy-wise, then?
Yeah, OK, so probably not on the race issues, because they're both saying pretty similar messages around co-governance and different things there. It'll be around Winston Peters and New Zealand First have typically been quite big spenders. ACT is very much about, we're not actually about spending money, we're actually about getting, you know, lower government spending, lower taxes, better value for money. So that's a natural area of conflict.
What about Chinese investment?
Maybe, but, you know, again, actually, David Seymour, from memory, and I might be wrong, I thought he'd made some comments which were a little more sceptical of that. I might be wrong.
Yeah,
on that,
the most recent comments was that he would said he would prevent New Zealand joining the Belt and Road Initiative.
Yeah, so, I mean, you know, and that's a massive initiative for China. Personally, actually, I think that's wrong. Yeah, you know, I'm not here to, you know, be the cheerleader for China. But I tell you what, Belt and Road's over a $1 trillion initiative with massive infrastructure build out across Asia, linking basically Asia to Europe. It has huge opportunities for New Zealand companies.
So would ACT have to fold on that if that was a demand?
Yeah. Look, I'm not Prime Minister. I'm never going to be Prime Minister again, so that's not a matter for me. But they'll decide.
All right, one last topic, tax cuts. We've had a lot of talk about National's credibility on the line here, and it's recently the figures have flattened out a bit more. They've been saying you'll get up to 250.
Yep.
That only applies to 3,000 people. Was that a bit disingenuous to be marketing on such a huge platform for such a small number of people?
No, not at all. Because, I mean, the reality is everybody knows when it comes to tax cuts, and this is one of the issues with tax cuts, you know, it depends on your household income, it depends on other variables, like do you have children, for instance, all those things.
But in the cost of living crisis, everyone was going, yes, please, give me some money.
Yeah, but, I mean, OK, and they will get money, that as opposed to not getting money from the other side. But, again, if you go and have a look at it, there's a reason National had a tax calculator out there, so every household could go and look at it.
Did have to adjust it for early childcare.
Yeah, I mean, OK, but look, those calculators are notorious, that you always have to do little bits and pieces. What I will say about this is Nicola Willis was one of my main advisors when I first became Prime Minister in 08. She is amazing. She's super bright, and she's really good, and she's really belts and braces. So they will have looked at all that. And you know, will numbers be perfectly right? Well, look, the Treasury came out with some numbers a few months ago on predicted tax revenue. A month later, with their supercomputer and the brightest people in Wellington, they were out by $2 billion.
Yep.
So these numbers move around a lot. It's more about philosophically, do you think the government should let you keep some more of your money and spend it, or do you think they should spend it on your behalf? National's messages...
Can people feel a bit disappointed then that it's not quite what they thought the public messaging coming at them was?
No, because I think, and again, I might be wrong because I'm not here to critique every bit of it, I don't watch every bit, but I'm pretty sure I heard Grant Robertson, these guys saying, oh, most households are going to get nothing like that, you're only going to get small amounts. So, look, everybody understands there's a range and it will depend on your income. So, again, if you pay a very, very small amount of tax, by definition, if you get a tax cut, it will be smaller. It's always the way of it. But don't forget, the whole aim of that tax cut package is to be very much focused on the centre, not the top end, very much focused on those who are probably in the greatest need, let's be fair, with young children and family.
Right. So, John Key, thank you very much for coming in this morning.
Thanks very much.